everyone. Kyle Erickson here. Something in my eye. No. Try this again. Now, customizing your iOS home screen is not something new by any means. We've been able to do this just over a year now with iOS 14, and I actually made a video for iPad on this very topic when iPadOS 15 was in beta. But I just wanted to carve out some time and show you some of the coolest customizations that I've found on iOS 15 that kind of builds on the changes that we saw in iOS 14. What if I told you that you could completely change your home screen from something like this to this, and then have it auto switch to this every day with only ever having to set this up one time? That's right, folks, there is a bunch of really cool stuff in here, and I know this can get tedious, but I think the end result is really cool. What we're going to do here today is set up two different home screens that auto switch based on the time of day. For this example, I'm going to have mine switch from light to dark when we hit evening and back to light when we hit the morning. So before we do anything here, you will have to have iOS 15 downloaded and installed on your phone. So if you haven't updated in a while, or you're still on iOS 14 or something older for whatever reason, you'll want to update that right now. Next, we are going to grab an icon pack. I've already got one downloaded, but you can find tons and tons out there. Some paid ones are really nice, and you can find them pretty cheap, anywhere between $10 and $25 usually. And there are a few free ones out there as well. I'll drop a few links down below with some options, but you can literally just Google iOS 15 icons or iOS 14 icons, and you should have a bunch of options to choose from. A lot of them have light and dark options available, which you will need if you want to swap the icons as well when we switch times, or if you have a set of white icons with a black background or vice versa. You can use some editing software and just invert those images to give you both a dark and a light set. If you don't know what I'm talking about, just grab a set that has both. Okay, number one, first thing that we are going to do is move these files to your phone, because there is a pretty good chance that you downloaded an icon set from somewhere on a computer. If you didn't, you'll just want to transfer those over to your phone. I just put them on my iCloud drive, but you can put them wherever just so long as they are on your phone. I'm also going to prep our backgrounds, so I'm just going to find a few wallpapers I like. One that I like for daytime and another one that I like for nighttime. And for both of those, I'm gonna go over to unsplash.com on the old interwebs to find what I'm looking for. I found a few of these, which I'll leave links for as well if you want to see these specifically. I know when I did the iPad video, a bunch of people still leave messages asking for links to background, so I will make sure to include those. So I am just going to download these. And then I'm just gonna be quick and dirty here, and I'm going to go to my downloads and save these as images. Again, you can transfer these any way you like. I'm going to go to my Photos app from there and hit the Albums tab at the bottom, and then hit the plus button to add a new album. I'm actually going to create two new albums. One I'll name Light Mode, and the other I'll name Dark Mode. And I'll add those photos that I just picked to each album. You can add as many photos here as you like to each album if you want to kind of cycle through some random ones each day, but I'm just going to keep things really simple and just have two, one in each album. Okay, so now we're all prepped to start building out some of these switchable home screen features. We can start off by heading to the Shortcuts app on your phone and clicking the plus icon to create a new shortcut. Once you've selected that and you're in the next view, you want to name your shortcut. I'm just going to call this Open YouTube. Click the Open App option here, or if you don't have that showing, you can search for it and select it. And then I'm going to go to the next line and click on where it says App to select my app. And I'm going to find and choose YouTube. From there, I'm just gonna hit the blue button with the sliders for an icon, and I'm going to click Add to Home Screen. Now, on this next screen, it's going to preview what your icon is going to look like on your home screen. So obviously we don't want this icon. And I'm actually just going to empty out this shortcut name as well because I don't want any text to show on my icons. And anything here will show just underneath your icon, just like it does on a regular home screen. But feel free to name that whatever you want. This is obviously your home screen. It's fun, it's exciting. We're doing new things here, people. Once we've done that, I'm gonna click on that icon just to the left of the name that I just removed and choose photo or choose file, depending on where you have these little bad boy icons stored on your phone. Then I'm going to click add, and there it is, our first custom icon. Now, pat yourself on the back. How do people even pat themselves on the back? I feel like I was a lot more flexible as a child. Now that you've stretched out and congratulated yourself, we are moving on. I'm going to hold down that icon to get into wiggle mode and just drag it over to this new view. And I'm basically just going to repeat this process until I get the icons that I want on my screen. And I am going to add the same icons in both black and white that are on different pages so that all the white icons are on one page and all the black on another. For the ones where I'm just making another icon color for an app icon that I just made, I can actually go back to my shortcut, and if it's not already open, I can hit the blue slider button on the shortcut and just click add to home screen again, and then just select my other icon color, and it creates a new icon based on the same shortcut. And we can kind of do this with the same thing at the dock on the bottom of the screen, but just know that this isn't going to switch in the same way that your actual pages will. I'm fine with just having a set of dark icons down here, but you can do whatever you want. Again, this is your phone, it's your creativity. Feel your inner voice. I'm also just going to add a widget or two, and for that I'm going to use an app called WIDGETSmith, which you can find on the App Store. And when you're in that app, you can select and customize a bunch of different widgets. Now, I'm just going to make a few simple ones, just a couple with black backgrounds and a couple with white. Just putting a few things that I might find useful on them and setting those up in the WIDGETSmith app so I can then just drag them onto my screens after. Then I'll head back into wiggle mode. That always sounds so ridiculous when I say it. Are you sure you're in wiggle mode? I'm obviously in wiggle mode, so I'm just going to add my widgets by selecting the plus in the top corner. So now I've got those two separate screens, one with light icons and one with dark. I'm just going to hide all my app screens except for the primary one. Let's use light for the primary screen. You can see that that is now our only app screen, but if I go back into wiggle mode, and then I hit that little paging button, you can see all my screens are still sitting here, which is great if you want to just try this out. You don't have to delete all your screens that you've set up or customize if you just want to revert back to them after. But we're actually going to need things set up this way anyways for the next step. Now, this is where things get interesting, my friends. We are now going to head over to focus mode, and we're going to create a custom focus, which is one of the new features in iOS 15. Let's call this one Switchy Pants. Don't judge me. You can call this whatever you want. Give it an icon and a color if you want to get fancy with it. And then the most annoying part, you select who you want to get notifications from. In this case, I'm not setting this up for anything but different visuals, but you could customize this to limit the amount of messages you get from certain people. If you also don't want to receive text messages from someone during the day, maybe you have a super annoying family member that contacts you throughout the day and just texts you random, meaningless things that you don't want to know. I don't know. The point here is that it's there if you need it, and the next screen is pretty much the same. It's just going to limit notifications for certain apps. So I'm just going to go through and check all of these and click the blue button at the bottom, and we've got our custom focus set up. We now need to do two things here. One, set this thing up so it shows a custom home screen when it's turned on, and two, add the conditions for when this does turn on. We're going to click on the home screen option and toggle custom pages. And from here, you'll see all your hidden pages that you can select. So we're going to select our page or pages if you've got multiple, and then hit done. Now that our pages are set up, we are going to go back and click add a schedule or automation. So there are a few different options here. We could select the time, which is what we are going to use, or we could do things like location. So when you reach a certain point or GPS coordinates, your phone will actually use GPS and it'll switch into focus mode, which could be useful if you are going to work and you want to limit some of the functionality on your phone when you arrived on the premises. But that's not what we're here for. So I'm just going to select time and say 6 p.m. to 9 a.m. And this is going to have my dark icons or my night setting. And we can click done or back after that. And I'm also going to switch my focus status to off so that when I send messages to people, they don't see my focus status, because in this case, it's irrelevant. Unless you really want someone to know that you're on the switchy pants focus. No one needs to know about switchy pants, or maybe they do.
You be the judge.
After that, we're all set up and this baby is active. This will toggle between our app icons, but we can actually go a step further and do the background as well. I'm going to drop a link in the description again to a shortcut called AutoWall, and you can copy and paste that into Safari in your phone and then click the open button in the top right, and it will open the shortcut directly in your shortcuts app. You can select the three-dot menu on the shortcut and edit this. So in this case, it's going to say find all photos where album is recents. And this is where those albums come into play that we created earlier. And we can click on that album and just pick the one that we made earlier. I'm going to select light mode. Once that looks good, we are going to close out of that and we are just going to click the shortcut and run it just to make sure that everything is working all right. It's probably going to ask you for access to your photos, and you want to always allow access to your photos. Once that's done, you can see a little check mark, but sometimes it does hang up here halfway through. But if you go back to your home screen, you can see it's actually worked and that my background has changed. Once that's confirmed, you can head back to your shortcuts app and hold down your shortcut and duplicate it. Then we're going to go into that shortcut by clicking that three-dot menu again, and all we need to do here is change the album to the other one that we created. We're going to click and run that again, just doing the same thing that we did before, just to make sure everything works. And all our wallpaper shortcuts are ready to go. But there's still one more step here. So we created the shortcut, but it doesn't actually do anything yet unless we run the shortcut from this panel. So what we need to do is create an automation to run the shortcut at the right time. So I'm going to head into the automation tab at the bottom of the screen in my shortcuts app, hit create personal automation, and we are going to click time of day. And then I'm going to make sure that time of day is selected and select 6 p.m. I'm going to leave this to repeat daily and click next. Now I'm going to add an action and just search for run shortcut. I'm going to select that, click shortcut, and select my AutoWall shortcut that I created. One thing that you need to make sure of here is that your automation is toggled to the off position where it says ask before running. Otherwise, this will never actually fire. Then I'm just going to repeat that process again for my other shortcut, but I'm just going to select 9 a.m. instead of 6 p.m. and obviously select my other shortcut. And then we are good to go. Now you've got everything set up to automatically switch or toggle once at 9 a.m. and once at 6 p.m. There is just one tiny little thing that's a little bit annoying that I do want to mention. You do get this notification pop-up saying that your shortcut was successful when you open an app from one of your custom icons. I know that on earlier versions, you could actually cancel this out so it didn't show up. And you did that by running an automation when you opened any of your apps, but it seems like things have changed a little bit there. It's something that we might have to live with for now. In any case, it's not that noticeable or annoying, but if you have found a decent solution that addresses this, feel free to comment down below. I know a lot of people like to have custom home screens and add a little bit of their own style to their phone, and I'm all for that, so I hope that you found this useful, and I'd love to see what everyone else comes up with their customization, so feel free to share what you have. I do periodically update my screens and my background and stuff on Instagram, so feel free to check me out there if you wish. If you enjoyed this video, spank that like button, and don't forget to subscribe for more tech-related content, and smack that bell icon too while you're at it. I hope you all had fun with me today, and I will see you in the next video. I I just wanted to carve out some time and actually show you some... Now there's more things falling. Ugh!